So every language you want to work with, the first thing you really to get comfortable with and kind of understand what it is variables, right? By the end of the day, the reason we're coding, the reason we use code in general, is we basically want to create some program or application that deals with different variables, deal with different customers, deal with different clients, deal with different things, right? So there's basically you want to build an application that handles all these different scenarios, right? So the first step in is really understand how we even feed those variables. How do we even put those variables in the code, and what are they? You can think of variables as your black box, right? It's a box that you can put whatever in and save it in a memory. And then later on, you can access that box, open it up and see what's in it and try to kind of do certain functionality based on those details and variables and contents in that box, okay? So to define a variable, right? Basically, again, kind of like we touched base on, variable is a memory. It's a space in the computer memory, right? It's taking a location. And it basically has three things associated with it. The first thing is a name. So every variable have to have a name, right? So we can say, you know, a student name is, for example, Adam, right? So that's my variable name. So the student equals to a value, which that value would be my real name. And then the second thing associated with the variables is a type, meaning like you could have different type of boxes, different type of variable, right? So it could be a number, it could be a text, it could be a lot of different things, right? But we want to keep it simple. Let's keep those text and variable as an example. Okay. And the last thing is the actual value. So, and this might look a little bit, you know, kind of strange, is you have a name and a value, but basically it's like, you know, assigning an address and actual content. If you're getting a mail, the mail is the address and the actual content is the letter inside the mail.
Ellen?
I'm sorry?
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I think this is the second class. Do you have the another one presentation?
Yeah, so this one is the presentation. The PDF is not PowerPoint, so I can't really present that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So again, let's just kind of confirm it. If I have a student, I want to create a variable called student. The variable name would be student, and the value of that would be the name of the student, which is, for example, Adam, Jesse, and the type of that variable would be a string. Okay, and that's how it looks in the code. So if I wanted to create a variable, I can first choose the type, then give it the name, and then give it the content. Okay, I want to introduce you to also IntelliJ and kind of show you as we go. So for Java, one of the most common editor to write code in is IntelliJ, right? If you're not familiar with it, if you haven't installed it yet, that's totally fine, no pressure. But you'll notice that when you go to your website, your account with Java Rush, if you sign up for the account, you'll notice that every problem or every task you're trying to solve, you'll also see a similar editor, right? And they're basically the same. So you can use your local one, or you can use the one plugin in the website, right? So this is my kind of like, you know, my way to write code and execute it, okay? We'll kind of dive in that a little bit more, but I just wanted kind of to show you. If I wanted to create a variable, I have all these kind of types, name and value. And you'll see that as I type, there's some color coding gonna be there that hopefully kind of give you an idea, right? So integer is short for int is short for integer, and that basically means numbers in a way, right? So I can say, hey, define a variable called a, and that is equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay. Also, the second type would be a string, we can actually take our example here. So we say student, and that equal to Adam. Okay. That's how creating variable works. The first part is the type, second part is the orange part is the name, and then the last part is the actual value. Okay. So I'm taking here an example, kind of like I'll show you in the editor. So I can do a string, which means literally dex, but that's how, you know, the terminology in Java. So string equal to dex, integer equal to numbers. So that could be any numbers, negative or positive, but it has to be a wholesome number. It can't be a fraction. And we'll talk about if what happened if we have a fraction. And the way to define it, again, you say integer x, integer s, integer a, b, c. You can, if you wanted to define one variable, all it takes is basically you define it and then add a semicolon. That's indicate the end of the line. Or if you wanted to identify multiple variable within the same line, you will say integer a comma b comma c. So the comma is indication of a second variable continuous to the sentence. The semicolon is the indication of end of the line. All right. So building on top of that, so now we're trying to like actually create a variable and assign it some value. So I have three variables, integer I, A, B, and X. I can define them, again, I can combine those together or define them separately. It's a matter of preference. There would be good reason to do either way, but for now, we just want to understand what's the possible, what's what we can do. And then after we define those, all of them are type integer, which is, we say int for short. So I can only assign numbers to that. So if I had a box, I'm gonna label it int, which means numbers. And now I can put in that box any number I want. Why? I wanna save that and maybe do something with it later, right? So I define three to I, just a basic number. And I define number one to A. So I have two of them now that has value three and value one, okay? Now, when I define B, I didn't wanna do it directly. Like I didn't wanna give it a value directly. I wanted to do a simple math. I wanted to do, take a variable called A already, which is I already defined number one, and then add one to that, okay? So if you see here, the purple, the B, took the A value, which is number one, and then I added one to that, and that resulted in two. So we can assign them value directly, or we can assign them through another variable, right? So that's kind of like the main point here. We did the same thing with X, but this time we didn't even use a different variable. We assign X to number three, and then we added, increased it by one. So the result of that is four. All right. So if you notice here, we defined x equal to three. We didn't say integer, and because we already defined x on top. So once you define it with a type that you want to use, you can use value directly assigned to it. You can increase, you can decrease, you can do whatever you want with it. You can see here, the name here represent I in this example. The equal sign is assign operation. It's like saying, hey, assign this value to this name. And the value is the actual value. In this case, we're using numbers, so it could be any number.